Hey guys, welcome to 1010 Hillcrest, probably one of the most famous and well-known houses in Truesdale because it belonged to Paul Truesdale. Truesdale Estates was founded in the early 50s and 60s. It was a part of the Doheny Ranch, which was a working ranch with orange groves and cattle and whatnot. So the Doheny subdivided it off and left 18 acres for Greystone, and the remaining 432 acres were subdivided by Paul Truesdale, who built all of these amazing houses. They were like the houses of tomorrow, the houses of the future at the time. And while some of them today might be dated and, you know, maybe not as interesting as this one is still perfectly preserved and has just the right amount of character that somebody would never want to touch this house, and they would want to preserve this forever. And it is one of the best architectural homes that I've seen in Truesdale. In fact, it was built by my favorite architect, John Wolfe, who was a master of Regency architecture. He was the person who really started the Hollywood Regency trend. And as you can see, the view is not too shabby at all. In fact, we have views of a house that just sold for $165 million, all of the flats of Beverly Hills, Century City, and of course the famous Sierra Towers, which is probably the most iconic building in all of Los Angeles. And of course, this wonderful dipping pool. Despite being perfectly preserved, this house has all the latest in technology, including a full Crestron system. The house can operate by the touch of a button. You can turn on your alarm, your air, your music, anything you possibly want by the touch of that button. This house was actually built as a couple's home, so it really doesn't have many bedrooms. In here we have the library, as you can see, the wood paneling. All of this has been restored to what it was originally. This is, I think, one of my favorite rooms in the house. Follow me down to the primary suite. So as I mentioned, it's essentially a one-bedroom house. You have one bedroom, library, maids, and chauffeur's quarters. I guess that's because they didn't want guests. So this is the primary bedroom, and as you can see, it is a hexagonal shape and has a phenomenal fireplace, which is over 120 years old. Follow me this way into the primary bathroom. You have his side and you have her side, or her side and her side, or his side and his side, whatever you may fancy. Even the hinges on this house, everything is the finest quality. Look at these. These are P.E. Guerin, which most of you probably don't even know what they are, but each hinge here is the price of an economical car, per se. This one's the price of a Rolls Royce. Now, if you follow me down this way, we're gonna go to the dining room and then straight through to the kitchen. This is one of my favorite rooms in the house. Notice this beautiful Dongia chandelier, mid-century, and this beautiful reflecting pool right here with the boy and the pissing fountain. Follow me through to the kitchen, which is quite large and features a family room adjoining it. Hey, by the way, check out that view when you're doing the dishes. Even though it's a mid-century house and maintains most of its fabulous old features, they've still updated it throughout the years, and you features this brand new kitchen, which they installed only a couple of years ago. And as I mentioned, there's one guest room in the house, and this is it. Now, this would be a great space for a private office, or if you're in the music business, a recording studio, or even a home screening room. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the tour of 1010 Hillcrest. Now get the f*** out.